Hey guys, welcome back to Paradise. So today I thought I'd go over a few tips on how to cook on a fire. If you've been following us, you know that we cook everything on fire and everything on our Dutch oven here. So, I thought I'd give you a few tips here. First tip, smaller is better. As you can see here, look at how small that fire ring is. It's pretty much the size of the Dutch oven. As you can see, well, here's my hand. Dutch ovens are pretty big, but still, that fire is super small. So go small and go low. Look at how low that is to the ground there. So you're pretty much, what you're trying to do is maximize the heat that's coming off of the flames to be right underneath the Dutch oven there. So you're maximizing it so you don't have to burn so much wood. The wood that I put in there is literally only going to be like maybe a few inches long. So you're not really like wasting and putting like these giant logs in and stuff. So just make sure you break them small and you already have them ready. So you can just throw them in when you're cooking, because it's not fun when the thing goes out to be trying to break up wood and stuff like that. So there's a few tips. Some other side tips here. Always have some rocks nearby. Always collect some extra rocks for your fire pit. I like to take them if it's like windy out. And I like to take them and like sit them up top here. And then kind of, oops, there we go. Sit them up top here and I kind of make a ring around the whole fire pit there. So it literally is kind of like a little hearth, I guess. And then that's going to keep most of the wind from getting into your flame. And again, that's why you build it low. So you're maximizing the flame down here. Because you see a lot of these fire pits out there and they're gigantic. They're obviously not for cooking. They're for trying to keep warm. And when you could just go in, sorry, I got smoke. Woo. When you could just go inside and get warm. But that's a waste a lot of wood. And when you're trying to live really simple and be out here for like a week at a time, you pretty much want to maximize your wood efficiency. So you want the smallest fire and you want it to be the most bang for your buck here. So you don't really have to collect too much wood if you're really using this method here. You're not going to be wasting it because the flames aren't going to be way out here burning, because that energy is going to nothing. You want it to be directly underneath the Dutch oven there or your cast iron. So I think, man, smoke really got me. So I think those are pretty much my main tips there. If you're trying to cook on fire, Dutch oven's definitely the way to go. I love having the lid, because if you're trying to cook outside and there's bugs and there's wind, you want to have a lid. We went like the first 2 years with just a pan, and that was a huge pain. The dogs would shake, the wind would blow, like dust would fly into it. This thing is just amazing, even if you're only one person. It's big, it's heavy, but it's definitely worth it, especially if you're going to cook all your meals on fire. That's the way to go. And then just have like a simple grate like this. We actually got this grate out of an old refrigerator that we found on a back road. It works really good. It's stainless steel. And it's pretty big and it's really sturdy. So you don't need to go buy one of those fancy ones at a camping store or anything. And then just have your spatula nearby. I usually just kind of sit it there. But man, smoke is good today. But anyways, those are a few tips there. I got to go before I choke to death on the smoke here. But as I said, my fire went out. But I got to get back to cooking. Hope you guys enjoyed those tips. If you like it, you know, make sure to hit like and subscribe. And if you have any comments on cooking on fire, let me know down below. Otherwise, we'll see you guys next time. Bye.